Darkness wants to hide the past and make me lose my way. I trust what I read on these pages. I wrote them for a reason. Cut through the reality, tear it apart, and rewrite it. They are drawn to the mystery.
Stuck. Let's go take care of it.
Thank you for meeting with us again, Dr. Hartman.
It's my pleasure, gentlemen. I hope the information I have is of
small use. It's been invaluable, Doctor. Really, we have a much clearer picture of this event, thanks to your accounts.
Well, I consider myself a keen observer. We did have one question.
I've forgotten again. Plan. I know it. I've forgotten.
Hartman.
Whatever is going on with Wake, he clearly needs some help.
Had to escape, right? His escape. Wake needed a hero. A hero needed a crisis. For the part in the story about the government agency, Wake needed something special, something to convey an alien force mimicking human intelligence.
Another replica, like the one they made for Ordinary.
Director Faden, I need a ranger dispatched to my position.
We're in this together!
These are the notes of Dr. Emil Hart.
Now it's not. Oh, Lacey, what? You are Director Faden here. I need a ranger dispatched to my position.
It's an honor, Director.
Director Faden here. Send backup to my location.
Thank you.
Hartman won't be a problem anymore, Langston. But investigations need someone to run it. Interested?
I've seen what happens to sector heads, ma'am. No, thank you. Ma'am, I'm getting something on my terminal here, an AWE alert from Bright Falls, Washington. But it might be a glitch. The date's all wrong, a couple of years in the future. And we're in lockdown. There shouldn't be any incoming signals.
Maybe it was active before we went into lockdown? Are there agents on site?
Let me check. Agent Estevez is the field agent in charge of monitoring the site, so she should be there to let us know if the situation has been through any major changes.
These are the notes of Dr. Emil Hartman. I am continuing my work alone.
This must be where they studied Hartman. Kinda looks like Dylan's cell. I wonder if they treated him as badly.
Thank you.
This must be the pit Underhill was talking about.
Ramsey, Ranger Captain, note 7.25. Underhill sent us down this weird-ass threshold looking for whatever they call these vegetables.
Oh, God. The further I go, the worse it smells.
Ramsey, Ranger Captain, note 7.28. Wait, 6.7. Still the threshold. I'll be straight up eating the vegetables now, because why not? Mom said, it's your vegetables. Eat too many of your Skittles. Hey, Ollie, what'd you find out?
Is that the source? It's...
Nope. Not pretty.
Stop being surprised by all the weird shit in this place.
Good.
You've returned, I see.
This is nothing. Clocks?
And you're not sprouting mold from your eyes. I take it that means my pill worked. Now tell me everything. Did you find the source? You did, didn't you?
I found a big, angry plant. Like, gigantic. I killed it.
You killed it? You found the source and you killed it? I could have learned so much from a live specimen.
Her concern is touching. Really, it's too much.
Here, I brought you a sample.
A piece of the innermost mold? You're not such a lost cause after all. Strange. So different, even superficially. Another stage of growth, perhaps.
Please, no more stages.
You'll be pleased to know that cutting down the creature at the source has already resulted in a notable cessation of the mold's rapid growth. You've bought me time for further study.
So what now?
I'm glad you asked. While you were busy in the pit, a number of mold hosts were sighted beyond the threshold. They managed to sneak out without the Rangers noticing. There's a reason I didn't send Steve and Andy to find the mold source with the others. These vagrant hosts must be eradicated as soon as possible. The mold can still be spread by their overgrown bodies.
Any idea where they went?
The hosts I've observed are not a sprightly bunch. Here are the reports I've received. They'll help you find them.
I'll go take care of them.
Good. And do be quick about it.
There's a nice way to say that.
I assume you'll be staying with us until the mold is eradicated.
Indeed. Until I find a permanent resolution to this pesky fungus business, I'll be here. Perhaps even beyond that, seeing as you are quite understaffed at the moment. Though I hardly have a say in my own comings or goings. Your oldest house won't open the exits until those hiss monstrosities are cleared out.
Glad to have you along for the ride. Will the mold be under control anytime soon?
We were barely containing it with weakly controlled burns. Just look at how it has spread after a few days of non-interference. It's beyond the threshold now. The floodgates are open.
So that's a no.
Americans.
With Darling gone, I'm putting Emily Pope in charge of the research sector. Are you okay with that?
Perfectly. You have pulled Excalibur from the stone, and now decree as you see fit, O Queen. What a true meritocracy we live in.
Glad to hear it. I had a dream. Or something like one. Darling was there. He told me something, but I can't remember what. I think he's gone.
Right. Well, he's never where one expects him to be, is he? Well, thank God. I can finally stop writing these tedious reports that I'm sure he never even took the time to glance at. If you speak to him again, can you tell him I... I hope he found what he was looking for.
I'll try.
I should be getting back to work.
I'll see you later, Rhea.
Dr. Underhill, if you please.
Be careful,
Dad. No need to hurry back.
I don't want to have to come save you. Seriously.